Hey everyone, it's Karen with Yes Please Paper Crafts, and today I'm in my craft room and I'm doing some scrapbooking. And so I have this layout that I started about a week ago and then I got stuck with it. So I thought maybe I would try to see if I could figure out a way to finish this layout. And so how I got myself into this situation is that I just randomly went over to my Calyx and pulled one of my collections and decided that I would just work with that collection. Then I went over to a stack of random pictures and I flipped through the pictures until I found pictures that I thought went with the colors in this paper. And so I didn't really look at the contents of the kit. So when I got to the point where I was embellishing, I found that the embellishments that were included in this kit don't really go with my layout. Okay, so I kind of got myself stuck. So I think in the future, I might spend a little bit of time reviewing the contents of a kit before I get started, and then maybe I won't find myself in this situation again. Okay, so this kit is the July 2019 kit. It came with these embellishments from the Hip Kit Club that are called Hello Summer, and so these are summer-themed embellishments, and they didn't really go with this layout. It also came with the Saturday Afternoon One Canoe 2, and I did use one of the little embellishments here. This is a three-dimensional embellishment. They're layered stickers. I was able to use this little rosette that says, "It's a beautiful day." I think that's just perfect for this layout. Okay, so in addition to that, I did use some of the puffy stickers for my title. They had this set of Pink Fresh Studio, just puffy phrase stickers from Just a Little Lovely. And so I used that to make the word memories. And then I also used some of these puffy alpha stickers. This is also from that same collection to spell out the word happy. So my title is Happy Memories. Okay, so the paper that I used was from a couple of different collections because this is a kit that was pulled together by the Hip Kit Club, and there's a lot of different manufacturers in this kit. And so I did use this paper from Webster's Pages. It's called Happy Day, and I think it might be from a collection called Love is in the Air, but I'm not sure. I also used a paper from Bella Boulevard. It's from the Home Sweet Home collection, and this is the paper right here. It's like a really bright yellow. Let me see if I can bring a piece of it over. I used quite a bit of this paper behind my pictures as one of the mats behind my pictures, and also behind this large rainbow paper. So it's this paper right here. Okay, and then I also used a couple of these papers. Let's see. I have a couple papers here. This one's a really funny paper. It's got all of these little flamingos on it, which is super cute. And on the back is this really pretty navy paper with a little swirly pink design. And so I kept that because at the time when I was creating this layout, I was talking to my friend Joanne Bartel, and she said, "This paper is awesome to mat a layout." And she suggested that I try to keep some of it. And so I just gutted the middle of the paper. And I used that paper actually behind my photos. And so you really can't see much of it. You can't tell that it actually has flamingos on it. It just adds a bit of pink behind the photo. I also used some of this paper. This is from the Echo Park Best Summer Ever collection, and it's a really pretty pink and white stripe. I just cut a couple of strips of that paper and put it at the top and the bottom of the layout. Okay, let's see what else. Also use this paper. This is the rainbow paper. On one side, it has the rainbow. This is from Webster's Pages, and it's also from the same collection, Love is in the Air. And I didn't use really anything from this side. I just used the rainbows. Okay, so those are all the papers and also the title. Okay, so for this rainbow here, that was one of the cut aparts. So one of the things that was on and was included in this kit was a cut apart from Webster's Pages. And I completely cut apart the entire thing. I have all these little pieces, and it was pretty much the only thing that was in this kit that I thought really went with my layout. And so I spent some time fussy cutting all of that out. I'm also going to bring in some of these puffy stickers because I think some of these will also go with this layout. Okay, so one of the things that was kind of funny about this was I already cut this up and I wanted to show you the actual paper before I cut it up, but since I already cut it up, I couldn't really do that. But then I got to thinking about it. I have a piece of this exact same paper in my stash. And so I went over to my stash and I grabbed it, and it took me like 30 seconds to find this paper. And so that was super exciting because I've been working on sorting and organizing all of my paper so that I can more easily find it when I need it. And so I was so happy that I was able to go over to my flip bin, flip to the category cut aparts, and then just flip through that paper that was the cut aparts, and I was able to find this sheet of paper. It was so amazing. So I just love that. I have a couple of videos on my channel where I talk about sorting paper and also my flip bin storage. And I will put links to all of those videos in the description below if you're interested in learning more about sorting and organizing paper. And I'm still working on mine. It's not finished. I still have a lot of paper to get through, to sort through. But I think that what I have done so far is working really, really well, and I'm just loving it. Okay, so I also have a couple of playlists on my channel. One is Organized With Me, and the other one I think is Organized Every Day. And I may have a playlist just for paper, so I'll have to see if I have one. If I don't, I might create one so that y'all can go just straight to that playlist and see all the videos on organizing and sorting 12 by 12 papers. Okay, so anyway, I have this cut apart to show you. So here is the cut apart. You can see I cut out the little rainbow here. I also cut out this little bird, this little rainbow with the fun, and these little houses. And those are the things I'm going to be using to finish my layout. I also took a couple of punches and I punched out some of the sayings. Like I punched out this rainbow is my favorite color, and then this little selfie and enjoy the little thing. So I just used a punch and cut some of these other things out. But the funny thing about this cut apart is that some of the things really suited my layout and the look and feel, but other things from this cut apart really just don't go with this layout. And so you'll see as I kind of show you the different pieces that I cut apart, how the different things from this particular piece of paper, some of them work really well and then some of them don't. Okay. So let's go ahead and see if we can go ahead and use these pieces. Now, I did think a little bit about how I was going to lay this all out before I started the video. And then I thought, well, maybe I will do a video and talk about this a little bit and how you can actually use the cut apart to make all of the embellishments that you need to finish a layout. And it's also a lot of fun, I think, to make your own embellishments. And I did really think about going back into my craft room and seeing if I could find some things to work with this layout. And then I came back to this kit, looked at the layout, looked at what was available, what I had left in the kit, and just decided to go with keeping it in the kit and trying to make it work with what I had available. Okay, so I did cut out this little bird. Isn't that cute? I just love that. I have the little rainbow fern. A couple of little houses, and this little house did have a bird on the top, but there's no way I was going to try to cut that out. So when I was fussy cutting, I just cut the little bird off, and there was actually a little lantern sticking out over here, and I cut that off too. So sometimes if there's things that you can't fussy cut, you might just chop them off. In this one, I did actually manage to cut out the little bird, which I thought was super adorable. Okay. So those were all the ones that I fussy cut. And then I used a circle punch and a scallop punch. And I cut out this little enjoy the little things. And I'm just going to layer it on top of this scallop. And then the same thing here. I did a larger scallop with the yellow and a larger circle. And I'm able to make this little embellishment with the rainbow is my favorite color. So those are super adorable. Also went ahead and just used a banner punch, and I just punched out three little banners. And I'm going to put these banners up here at the top of the page somehow. And then I decided that I was going to try to see if I could do something with this area down here of my layout, because if you look at this layout, there's a kind of a large blank space over here. And I thought I didn't really want to make another cluster. And because Bella is kind of down on this picture, I can't really overlap anything on the picture here because it would kind of cover up her, and I don't want to do that. So I thought I would build something down here, kind of connect it to the title down here. I think it's good sometimes when you're working on a layout to try to make things connected. And so I'm just going to build out of my title, and I'm going to just go ahead and layer these little houses over here. And then I also thought it would be fun to put the rainbow. So I think I might layer the houses, and then I might pop this little rainbow up. And maybe I'll do it like this. So I'm going to pop this little rainbow up as if it's a rainbow in the sky. And I think that will be super cute. So we're going to put that over here. Okay, and then I have this little bird, and I actually did move the little bird around to different areas. And I actually decided that I would put it over here on the rainbow. And then I have these two little embellishments that are like the scallop circles. And I have another spot on my layout that I think needs something. And over here on this corner of this picture, there's a lot of green. And so I thought maybe I could tie these two pieces into my title down here just by layering them on top of the picture here. And I'm going to glue this one down and then pop this one up a little bit. So this one will be up on foam tape. Now, one of the things I kind of wished would be that I would have maybe done the reverse of this, and I might go ahead and change the color up a little bit and maybe pick a different color to go under this one and use the yellow here. Just because there's yellow, there's so much yellow over here on this side of the paper, I might change the scallops out a little bit and do it that way, because if I could layer it this way, I would have, but if I do that, there's not as much room on this side of this cut apart. There's a lot of empty space over here, and so I think I can layer these on top of each other going this way. But anyway, so I think I'm going to change the scallops out, and that won't be a problem. I can just punch some more paper and do that. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and glue all this stuff down, and then I'll be back. So I thought it would be fun to share a little information about the pictures that I'm using for this layout, because if you've watched my channel in the past, you know that I have two dogs, two Yorkies, Bella and Lilybell, and their hair is always short. Well, sometimes it gets a little long, but for the most part, it's much shorter than what you see here in this picture. Now, these pictures were taken about maybe 6 years ago when they were 4 years old. And their hair used to be a lot longer. And at that time, it was a little bit easier to take care of it. And my dogs were going to a groomer's once a week to have a bath and to get a little bit of a touch up on their haircut. Because she had this program that if you would bring your dogs every week, she would just charge a very small fee. I think it was like $10 or $12. And you could get a weekly hair appointment. And my dogs just love going to Miss Holly. And then when Miss Holly retired and she closed her business, I couldn't bring them to a place like that. I mean, you guys know if you get your dog's groom that the cost just to go one time is probably somewhere around $50 or up. And so I started bringing them maybe once every couple of months. And so it was a lot harder and a big challenge for me to try to maintain their long hair, especially since my dog Lilybell is a tenderhead and she does not like having her hair brushed. And unfortunately, her hair gets matted and tangled because it's baby fine. So anyway, these pictures are from a long time ago when they used to have long hair. I just think these are the most adorable pictures of my dogs. Okay, so I have almost everything glued down. I still have these two pieces that I'm still trying to figure out. I do have this one popped up onto some foam tape. And I also have brought in this puffy sticker. This was from this just a little lovely collection from Paintbrush Studio. And I was thinking that it was blending a little bit too much into the background when I just set it there on the layout. So I went ahead and grabbed a punch. This is a punch from Creative Memories. It is a Sun Punch. I think this one is no longer available. It's a retired punch, but you might still be able to find this on eBay or possibly from one of the Facebook groups that sells some of the, like a resale group. And I'll put links to a Facebook group. It's like a In Search of a resale group for Creative Memories products. I'll put that in the link below. If you want to join that group, it's an awesome way to be able to find some of the discontinued products. Okay, so I went ahead and punched it out of this really bright yellow paper, and I'm just going to layer that on top. I think it's so cute. It makes it look like a little sun, and it makes it stand out a little bit more from the background and from the house that's next to it. So we're just going to go ahead, and I'll go ahead and glue that down. Now, the other thing that I wanted to bring in, I decided to bring in a couple of flare buttons, and I did that because when I was working with these two pieces here, I just thought I needed something additional in this cluster, and so I wanted to bring in a flare button. I'm going to put it right here, and then I also needed to add something up here, so I'm just going to add in a couple of flare buttons. I thought that would be super awesome. So all of the flare buttons that I have over here are from my stash. I actually made these using my button maker, and all of these buttons are also available in my button shop. And if you're interested in finding out more about the buttons, I have a video where I talk about the buttons in my button shop, and I'll put a link to my store in the description below as well. It's yespleasepapercrafts.com/shop, and then once you get there, you'll see all the different buttons. I have almost 700 different designs, and I will be doing a new release for February. I'll be putting out some more designs here shortly, probably sometime this week. Okay, so let's see what else. I'm also going to, I think, use a couple of these puffy stickers. And I wanted to bring something up here that was maybe blue or green, since we have a lot of blue and green in the different areas. And so I think I'm going to maybe use one of these puffy stickers, maybe this arrow up here. And I think that's really cute. And I love that saying. It says, "This brings me real joy." And my dogs definitely bring me a lot of joy. And I also wanted to use another puffy sticker maybe up here in this cluster. So let's see, what else do we have here that maybe I could add up there that would fit in? Some of these stickers really just don't go with my layout. Like this one says, "Do it for you." And some of them don't really suit the look and feel, or they're not the right color. So it's a little bit of a challenge to use it, but I am going to try really hard to just use the things that I have here. And I could bring in this little heart. I think that's really cute. I might put that, I don't know, it's sometimes things just blend right into the background. It makes it a little bit of a challenge, but I think I'll just put it there for now. And then let's see, what else could I put over here? Would anything work? I like this happy thoughts, but I don't really like the green on there. Maybe I won't put anything. Some of these floral stickers, they don't really suit the look and feel of my layout. They're more sophisticated and the colors are a little bit more muted than these bright colors. So I think maybe that will be all of these stickers that I bring in. Let's go ahead and look at these flare buttons. I was actually thinking about, I really like this one, and I tried that one there, but I really think that I like this one better. These buttons are a little different. This one is a plastic flat back button, and this is the default option in my store. If you buy any of the buttons, it'll come as a flat back with a black plastic back. And then I also have the other back options available if you want to choose that option when you're shopping. There's options for the open back, for the metal flat back, and also for the pins. And the difference is that this one, which is the black plastic flat back, it's a lot less dimensional. It still looks like a flare button, and it's really cool, but it's not as thick as these other ones. So you can see there the difference in the size of the flare button. Okay, so I think I'm going to put this one here like that. And I think that's cute because it makes the hearts look like they're dangling. And I think this is a perfect one for this layout because it has the yellow, the orange, and the pink. And I just like how that kind of connects this little cluster here to my title. Okay, and then I thought I would maybe bring in another one. I really like this one here. It says, "You color my world." And I thought about putting that one over there. But I'm not sure. I think my layout's getting a little bit busy, so I could put it up here. The other one that I really like was this little rainbow. I could bring the rainbow up there, and I think I like that one better. Okay. I'm not sure I'm feeling this puffy sticker. I think it's going to go back onto the sticker sheet. All right, let's go ahead and just stick that back on there. I don't think it was standing out enough against the background there, and I just think that that's cuter with the little flare button. So I think we're good. I think that's going to be pretty much it. I'm just going to go ahead and glue these down, and then my layout will be finished. So I think it's a lot of fun trying to use kits and trying to see what you can do with the different kits, and using cut-aparts is really a lot of fun. I love to make my own embellishments, and so I think you can really stretch your supplies when you make your own embellishments to use with your layouts. So let's see if we can get this to go on there. I wanted to try to cover up this little corner right here and just kind of overlap it a little bit. And so we're going to do that. Now that this is together, this is also popped up onto some foam tape. I'll go ahead and make sure that the words are going in the right direction. And then I'm going to just grab a glue dot and go ahead and glue that down, and I'll glue this down. The other thing I need to do before I do that, I just need to flip this over and trim this right here because the banner is sticking up a little bit over the edge of the paper. All right, I think that's really cute. One of the things that I did here to make these banners pop out is I actually did put some foam tape just under the very edges. So it's glued down there at the edge, but it's popped up a little bit, and I think that's really cute. So, I hope you guys are all staying warm out there. It's cold here in Louisiana where I am, and I believe it got down to about 20 degrees last night. Pretty much the whole night was just cold. And for Louisiana, that is super, super cold because we usually don't even get sometimes winters here that go below freezing. So, it's probably one of the coldest winters that I can remember in a really, really long time. We didn't get any snow, but yeah, we just did get some really, really cold weather. Okay, so I think that's it for this layout. It did get a little busy, but I'm okay with that. My layouts do tend to get busy, but I just love all of the color and the embellishments, and I just love to build up the dimension and just give it a little bit more than just a flat layout. And this is kind of my style. So, I hope y'all enjoyed this scrapbook process video. And if you did, please give this video a like. And if you would like to see more videos, please subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you as a subscriber. So, I do have a short video clip of my two dogs, Bella and Lilybell, and I'll put that at the end of this video. I'm also going to share some close-ups. So, I hope you guys stay warm out there. Have an awesome week, and I hope to see you next time. Bye now.
I miss Bella with the messy hair. Were you sleeping? Your hair looks smushy. You got a smushy face? What you got to say for yourself? Are you staying warm? You and Lilybell were outside running around, outside in the cold and the dark. Yeah, y'all wouldn't come inside. I can't believe y'all were out there and it was like 25 degrees. I know. It was cold. Yep. You gonna say anything? Can you say hi to the YouTube people? No? Where's Miss Lilybell? Lilybell! Really? Is Lilybell sleeping? I think she's sleeping, huh? What's he doing, sweet pea? Are you gonna say hi? Can you talk to us? You don't want to talk? You're not talking today. You're not in the mood. You're not in the mood. Well, I can't see you if you get that close. Silly dog. Oh, now you're going to ignore me? Okay, be that way. Bella, are you going to say anything? She's ignoring me. Wait till she looks over here to see if I'm paying attention to the fact she's ignoring me. Miss Bella. Okay, you're going to go away? Okay, I'm going to go talk to Lilybell now. Let's go talk to Lilybell. Lilybell! Uh-oh, I woke her up. Hi, Miss Lilybell. What's you doing? Are you having a snooze? Do you want to say anything? No, you're not going to talk to me either. Lilybell. Lilybell, can you say hi? No. Okay, then. Y'all won't talk to me. They're just having a lazy day today. So, Miss Bella, you got anything else to say for yourself? Do you want to say hi? No. Okay, well, I guess that's all we have. Y'all take care. Hope to see you next time. Bye now.